हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू स्टैंडर्ड 10 सब्जेक्ट मैथमेटिक्स चैप्टर 11 कंस्ट्रक्शन। दिस इज लेक्चर नंबर 7। नाउ वी आर एन एक्सरसाइज 11.1 क्वेश्चन नंबर 7 एंड द लास्ट क्वेश्चन ऑफ दिस एक्सरसाइज वी हैव। इन दिस व्हाट इज गिवन, ड्रॉ अ राइट ट्रायंगल इन विच द साइड्स अदर देन हाइपोटेनस आर ऑफ लेंथ 4 सेंटीमीटर एंड 3 सेंटीमीटर। Then construct another triangle whose sides are 5/3 times the corresponding sides of given triangle. So in solution, as usual, we will write data first. Here again, the triangle's name is not given, so we will give the triangle name ABC. It is right triangle, so let the angle B is of 90 degree. If angle B is 90 degree, in rough you see this way. ABC, B is 90 degrees. So AC is hypotenuse and AB and BC are not. So in the question, other than hypotenuse length are given. Means AC length is not given, AB and BC given. So that's why in data I have written AB as 4 cm and BC as 3 cm. Now, drawing this given triangle, we have to construct another triangle whose sides are 5/3 times the corresponding sides of the given triangle. Means the required triangle is bigger than the given triangle here, because required triangle's ratio is 5 and given triangle's ratio is 3. This is the scale factor given. So first we draw the given triangle. For that, what we do? To draw the given triangle, what we have? AB and BC, both the length we have. So first I'll draw BC of 3 cm on the base side. Here BC drawn of 3 cm length, it is given, and AB is of 4 cm. B should be 90 degree angle. So how to draw 90 degree angle on B, that we have seen in last lecture. So here we will draw the same way. We have to take an arbitrary radius and take your rounded point on point B. Take some arbitrary radius this way and draw an arc this way. The big arc we will draw, and from here to here by the same radius, don't change it. If we go ahead on taking the rounder here, this way we will get 60 degree angle, and on then if we go ahead from here to here, it will be 120, double of 60. And between 60 and 120, we know that 90 degrees there. So from 60 degree angle, put the rounder and draw this arc. And from 120 degree point on this arc, we will intersect this previously drawn arc. This intersection point, which we join with the B point, it will give us 90 degree angle. So this is our 90 degree angle we got. So two things we got, BC equal to 3 cm also we have seen, angle B 90 is done, and now where is the point A? Is 4 cm away from B. From B it is 4 cm away. So we will take the radius now 4 cm. Take the radius this way and take your rounded point on B, which we know, and by this radius of 4 cm intersect the ray which is making 90 degree on B, and say there the name as A. So this way, if join AC, A to C we have to join, we will get the given triangle actually. This is the given triangle, right triangle we have now, ABC. Now this is the given triangle ABC. On that, now next triangle we want is PBQ of ratio 5 and 3 is of given ratio. So given triangle is smaller, the required triangle is bigger. So we have to extend BC this way. And on that B point, we have to take a ray which is making acute angle on BC. Say ray BX. On that, how many arcs we will have now? So between 5 and 3 ratio given, scale factor given. Which number is bigger? 5 is bigger number. So 5 arcs you draw on that B, BX ray. Taking some suitable length of the radius, we will draw 5 arcs on it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 arcs must be there. So we will take the length that way. Take some smaller, yes. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Give name these arcs as B1, B2, B3, B4, and B5. Now, 3 is the given ratio and ABC is the given triangle. So B3 is given ratio arc and C is the given points, given triangles point. So we will join B3C here. B3C is joined. Now we will draw another line segment which will be passing through B5 and parallel to B3C, because 5 ratios triangle we need. How to draw? As usual we do, we will put our rounder on B3. We will take some arbitrary length. This way I have taken this much of length, some bigger length also we can take. But the condition is, the arc should be intersecting ray BX as well as ray B3, as well as B3C point both. So this way the arc drawn, which is intersecting both BX ray and B3C. And by the same radius, now put your rounder on B5. And by the same radius, draw same way, similar way the arc which we have done from here. Now what we do, we take the length between these arcs intersection point with BX and B3C. So we will take the length between this point and this point. This will be the radius. So rounder point here I am taking, and the pencil point stretch, and this length we have to get and make a mark to get the that we have taken this much of length. Now by this length of radius which we have taken between these two distance, put your rounder point on this intersection point of arc and BX here, and pencil point with that intersect the arc. This intersection point and B5, join this B5 to intersection point and extend it up to ray BC. Here, this point will be P point, which is parallel. B5P is drawn now. B5P is parallel to B3C. Now the next point, as we do, we'll draw PQ parallel to CA. The similar way as we have done in previous lectures, we will put your rounder on C, take some arbitrary length of radius and draw this way an arc which is intersecting both BC and CA. And by the same radius, put your rounder on P point now, and similar way we will draw a ray this way. Then what to do? Then take the length between these two arcs intersection point with BC and CA. So that means the point here to here distance we have to take. That we will take. Rounder point is on this point, and pencil point we have to make sure that it is up to this point. This way the arc is taken. This way the radius is taken. By the same radius now, similar way, put your rounder point here, intersection point of arc and BP ray. And by the same radius that we have taken here, draw an arc which is intersecting the previous arc. Now we have this point of intersection and this point P, join them and extend up to ray BA, which is making 90 degrees. Extend up to ray BA. It is going this way. Ray BA is a smaller area, so we have to extend it up to make sure that where the intersection point is. So make it longer, make it higher. And here we are getting the point. So there only we will give the name as PQ. Don't bother about that it is intersecting in between the written things or where. Your construction must be correct. If it is going somewhere here and there and it is intersecting somewhere else, it should be on the base and it should be it may be anywhere on the written things also, no problem is there, but your correct triangles must be made. So this is our correct triangle PBQ we have of 5 ratio and ABC we have of 3 ratio, and this way the construction is over. Now we'll write the steps of it. So steps are, first step, again the same way we have constructed the triangle ABC of given measures. So construct triangle ABC with given measures. Next, what we have done? Next, ray BX is drawn, so that we will write about. Construct ray BX such that angle CBX is less than 90. Next, on ray BX, how many arcs we have taken? 5 arcs, because the greater ratio is 5. So construct 5 arcs on ray BX, say B1, B2, B3, B4, B5. With constant radius. Next, we have joined B3C. Why B3C? Because 3 is the given ratio and C point is the given triangle's points. So join B3C. Then we have constructed B5P parallel to B3C and PQ parallel to CA. That about we have to write. Construct B5P and PQ such that B5P is parallel to B3C and PQ is parallel to CA. PQ parallel CA. So thus we have the triangle PBQ and it is required triangle. Thus triangle PBQ is required triangle. So this way all the 7 questions of exercise 11.1 we have constructed, and this is also the completion of first type of construction in this chapter, that is division of a line segment. In that type it all the construction comes, this type of all the construction comes. And in next lecture now we will see the next type of construction, which is on a course, and that is a tangent to a circle. So you are advised to construct these constructions at least 5 times for your more practice, because this comes in 4 marks and you have only 5-6 minutes to complete it. We have to show it data to construct construction in all the construction very carefully and clear should be. And then steps you have to write very clearly to get all full marks 4. And we can do this only when we practice well, and at least 5 times you have to practice for this type of construction. Thank you.